Hi everyone, it's Summer Rae here, and today I'm filming my very first YouTube video. This has always been something that I've wanted to do. I just never really knew when the right time would be, but I never dreamed that it would be under these circumstances. You know that I always try to keep it real with you guys and stay completely authentically me, but the subject is a more serious topic and very stressful towards everyone. So I just want to make sure that I'm remaining respectful and professional while still being me. I know that the topic, the coronavirus, is huge right now. And this is something that I'm not only going through, but that we are all going through. And we all have a story in this, and we are all on this side of history. So today I'm sharing my story. Thursday, March 12th, I received a phone call from one of my best friends giving me the news that most all students had already received, that they were gonna have an extended 3 weeks to be out of school. So she told me she was headed to my side of the city to get groceries. And you guys know me, I always try to stay positive and make everything bright. So I told her, hey, why don't we go to our favorite lunch spot? They have drink specials, let's just go and have a great time. And she was like, yes, that sounds amazing. So on the way to the train station, I noticed that there is this weird, eerie, calm feeling, and not like a normal calm. This was very different. Usually the train stations are crazy, people everywhere. It's like a real life Mario Kart of everyone. On this day, everyone was quiet and no one was hardly there. We get to our favorite place, we're having a great time, but we can't help but bring up the topic, the coronavirus. And as we're getting ready to leave, she goes, so, you know, I'm staying in New York City, and because of this, my mom sent me some face masks. So, okay. Background, quiet. I'm just kidding. So after we've had a couple of drinks, you know, we're feeling good, we decide to put the face mask on. The end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world. Conveniently enough, there is a CVS that's right next door, so we decide, let's go get some hand sanitizer, some gloves. We go there, and it is
all gone.
All gone.
It's the end of the world as we know it. Gone.
Thankfully, we managed to find some gloves, and as we're checking out, we look down and all of the employees have gloves on. So that's when I pulled out my phone and I decided to interview him and ask him what he felt about the coronavirus. Are you nervous about the virus?
No.
No. One vote for no.
Part of me's worried, but also part of me's like, you know, mass hysteria.
Yeah.
Stuff like the media is like definitely making it bigger than it is. You've heard doctors say that like people have died, more people have died from the flu than coronavirus so far. So.
Do you want some gloves to protect yourself?
Are you scared or nervous, or you don't care? You're scared. Yeah. It is very scary. Thing that I know that I will never forget is the part of the city that we are in is absolutely gorgeous and so unique. There's this huge glass building that doesn't even look real. There's this huge black square that people can push around. It's such a unique part of the city, and you look around and it's quiet, it's totally empty, and you can hear sirens in the background. I get home and receive a phone call from my mom expressing that she is extremely worried about this entire thing and really wants me to come home. And although I have experienced the shift within the city, I truly wasn't ready to leave. And I told her, I was like, no, I think it'll be fine. Like, let's just wait until the weekend and we'll see how things go. And hi, sister. Say hi, Busta Boy. The night comes around and me and my friends are all texting, and we decide, whatever, we're gonna go out and just try to enjoy life and not think about things too much, whatever. So I get ready, I'm in my little outfit, I put on my gloves, put on my little mask. As I'm leaving, my precious little doorman pulls me inside and he says, "How are you doing? Are you gonna go home?" And I was like, you know, my mom, she really wants me to go home. I don't wanna go. And he looks over at me and he says, "Well, almost everyone in this building has already gone." That moment that I was one of the last to leave the city. We get to the oh so famous One Oak and walk in. It's the deadest I've ever seen it. And not only that, but there are literally, the few people that are there are dancing around with gloves and face masks on. So as we're all hanging out, trying to make the best of it, one of my best friends, who is a promoter for One Oak, sits down and I go over next to him and I'm like, "How are you doing? Like, you seem a little, you know, off." And he says, "I've seen brighter days. With no one coming to the clubs, they're not gonna pay me. And not only that, but the clubs might shut down." Fast forward to the future and all of the restaurants, bars, and clubs in New York City have now shut down. Around 10:30, I received a phone call from my parents saying, "We bought you a ticket home, you're coming home today. Be at the airport by 2:30 because you don't know how the airport's gonna be." I was given 3 hours to pack up my entire life and come home not knowing when I will return to the city. And that answer is still the unknown. In that situation, I do the best I can. I pack what I know I need, order the Uber, and this moment really just physically moved me and made me realize how serious the scenario really is. I get into the Uber and I look down and I see a pair of gloves and a face mask. I get to the LaGuardia Airport, and I've been to that airport many times. It's the one that I always take, and I get in there, and the line to the Southwest, which is what I'm flying, is the longest line I have ever seen in my entire life, okay?
This is insane.
In that specific moment, you really start to see the impact that this is having. Everyone is trying to get out of New York, and no one was prepared for it to be this crazy. So there's panic everywhere. There's panic about the virus. There's people behind me that are panicked. They're not gonna make their flight because they didn't realize how crazy the airports would be. I go through the line, wait for my flight. Everyone is wiping down their seats, wearing the mask. The guy next to me, we told each other stories. We related to one another. We both had the mask on, and we tried to make the moment as positive as we could. After spending all day traveling, I get home. Mask on, fuck your mask on, mask on, fuck your mask on. And the circumstances are completely different. I am from Panama City Beach, Florida, and no cases had been found within Bay County. So everyone here at the beach was acting like nothing was happening. And to go from such different scenarios was the weirdest feeling. Yesterday was truly the first day that I started to see people in Panama City Beach realizing, okay, this is serious. And I remember we went to Target and my sister goes to look for the little cleaning wipes for the buggy and there are none. And the lady in front of us says, "Here, I have some wipes for you. Please take them." I think now the world has truly realized how much of an impact this is really having. And so now it has affected everyone, even if the virus has not popped up yet in your county. And I just know that on the way home yesterday, I asked my mom, "Have you ever seen or been through anything like this?" And she looked over at me and she said, "No." And that's why I just felt so compelled to share my story, because I know that I was already kind of sharing some of this on Instagram and Snapchat, and I had so many people tell me, "Thank you for sharing this. Like, this has made this real for me. Thank you so much for showing me that this is actually happening and taking place." And so I really wanted to just document this because we are all on this side of history and none of us know what's gonna happen. We should all stay safe, remain positive, and be there for everyone. And I, weirdly enough, am truly thankful that I got to experience what I did in New York City. And I just hope and I pray that soon I get to return to one of the greatest cities in the world. If you've made it to the end of this, thank you so much. I really would love to start doing more videos. So if you have any cool ideas or have any more questions, please drop some comments. And of course, I would love if you would subscribe. I appreciate all of you. And I hope that you all remain positive and happy through these darker times, because there are brighter days ahead. Now that I can't put this down, if I